Ilana here from teachtraffic.com, recording a video for measureschool.com. And in today's video, I'm going to walk you through the 5 steps that you need to take to optimize your Google search campaign. I'm going to walk you through a live Google Ad account and show you each of these steps that you need to look for in your account to hopefully improve your results even further. So let's head on over to the account and we'll get stuck right in. Okay, here we are in a live Google Ad account. We're looking at about a 30-day period, so October 14 to November 17. And as you can see here, we've got clicks versus conversions, and conversions are sales. Okay, so the number one metric that you're going to be looking at when you manage your account, it's the metric that you live and breathe by, is really your cost per conversion or your cost per sale or whatever it is, the conversion that you are tracking, okay? How much did you pay to acquire that lead or sale? And in this instance, it is a sale, sending people to a retargeting challenge. So I need to weigh up my cost per lead of $80 basically here, and how I can take steps to reduce that cost per conversion and hopefully improve my conversion rate. And so this video is really going to walk you through that. So the first step is to really have a look at your cost per conversion and determine if that is at a threshold that you're happy with. If it's at a threshold that you are happy with, then it makes sense to really perhaps increase your budget and really try and ramp up spend. Okay, but really, if it's not, or always, we're always looking to try and improve, then step two is to really look at what's called your search term report. So if I go into this campaign, it's obviously a search campaign, and let's say I go into one of the particular ad groups. There's a discrepancy between the keyword that you're bidding on and what somebody actually typed into Google, which is the search term. And as you can see here, we've got search terms. So this is what somebody actually typed into Google, that where my ad was triggered and possibly even clicked on. So my search keyword here is I'm bidding on Facebook retargeting, or just retargeting on its own, Facebook remarketing, etc. And the search term is somewhat different. So 30 people have typed in how to retarget on Facebook, of which one person clicked on the ad. So really my job here is to have a look through these terms to decide which terms I do not want to show up for in future. So for example here, retargeting solutions, that must be a business name or something. I don't actually know what that is. So let's say I want to add solutions as a negative keyword because that's not really applicable. So I'll just copy this and I'm going to go to negative keywords and I'm going to go plus. And this is my way of adding a negative keyword. I want to add it actually at a campaign level. So I want this negative keyword to apply to all the ad groups in this campaign. And I'm just going to copy in solutions like this. I'm not going to put any kind of syntax around this word. I just want any instance of the word solutions to be prevented from showing up. And I click save. And then we go back to search terms. I'm just going to refresh that page. And then what you'll be able to see is then it will hopefully be excluded from future ones. So really my job here is to look through here to see which of other possible negative keywords. So FBX would be another one as well. And so you can download this into Excel. That's often what we do. We download this report. We make a short list of all the possible negative keywords. And then we just go to negative keywords and add them this way. Okay. So that is what you need to do with this. First thing you need to do with the search term report. The other thing you need to do is you need to really look through them to see if there's any other keywords that you might want to add, you know? So possibly I might want to add Facebook retargeting pixel as a possible keyword, maybe in its own ad group, and then write an ad that talks about, you know, that we've got training on how to install the pixel and where to find the pixel code, etc., which we do cover. Okay, so your job is really to match the term with the ad that you're showing someone and where you're sending them to. Okay, so there's really, as I said, twofold: adding negatives and adding possible keywords. All right, the other thing that you might want to have a look at is your ads. Okay, so look at your click-through rate to see if you could possibly improve the click-through rate at all. And this also, you know, is an extension, even though this is strategy number three, because you're really having a look at your search term report to see, should you change your headlines to really kind of get in the mind of the moment that somebody's in on Google. Okay, so here we talk about pixel retargeting tutorials, and obviously this ad does not get as good a click-through rate as this one, so we might look to pause this ad, create another ad for another possible split test, and write some different headlines. Okay, so that is strategy number three. The fourth thing that I want you to look at is quality score. That is a big factor to the success of your campaigns. So if we go into this other ad group, you'll see that some of my keywords here have what's called a low quality score. If you're not sure what quality score is, there's three factors that comprise quality score. The first is click-through rate, the second is relevance score, and the third is landing page experience. And if you have a low quality score, basically you're going to pay more for a cost per click. If you have a really good quality score, then you will pay less for the cost per click. So I guess Google is not really a traditional auction in the sense that the person who's willing to bid the highest gets the number one ad spot. Quality score really has a big effect on how much you pay per click, as well as where you are in the ad pack. Okay, so generally speaking, the way we improve quality score is by stripping these keywords out from this ad group and put them in their own campaign, in their own ad group, and write an ad that really talks directly to that particular keyword. Okay, and sometimes I've had instances where, you know, even doing that hasn't really helped it for whatever reason. Google doesn't like it. So possibly we change ads to improve our click-through rate and ad relevance, write a more compelling ad that will hopefully improve our click-through quality score. Okay, so that's the fourth thing that you need to look at. And finally, the last step that you need to look at is your keywords that might be below first page bid, as you can see here, below first page bid. So here I'm bidding 60 cents for this single keyword, which I normally wouldn't do. I just did for training purposes. And Google's telling me in order for my ad to be on the first page, I have to bid at least $1.66. For this one, $4.27. So you can see these different keywords have different bids. Okay, so you need to decide if you want to bid at that certain level in order to be on the first page. And as you can see here, Facebook retargeting one keyword is $11.54. You know, it's crazy prices. So you want to look for keywords that are below first page bid, and possibly consider doing Google's automated bidding. And as you can see, I've sort of navigated to the top here because I want to show you, here's where we were doing manual bidding, where we were below first page bid. The strategy here was intentionally to bid low so we could find the negative keywords to add so that we don't waste money on bidding top dollar for keywords. Once we find our negative keywords, actually we switch to Google's automated bidding. So as you can see here, I put a note here, a switch to maximize conversions. And as you can see, then our clicks increased and we started to get some sales. So a transformation in this account. Okay, so Google's automated bidding is where you don't bid on the cost per click. Google does all the bidding for you. So I did a bid strategy called maximize conversions. The idea of doing that temporarily to then transfer it into target CPA bidding. Okay, so I'm going to show you how to do that last really quick. Go into the campaign, go into settings, and we're going to change this at a campaign level. We go into bidding, change bid strategy, and then we want to do maximize conversions. If you want to set a target cost per acquisition, kind of going back to strategy one of really managing your account as per cost per conversion, you could do that. So let's say I want to set a target cost per acquisition of $50, but you run the risk of maybe Google not giving you impressions and you're not getting clicks. So starting out with, I like to do maximize conversions to get some data under the belt and then look to try and reduce the cost per conversion that way. Okay, so I'm going to click save. And then if we go into one of the ad groups, you'll see here that I've got no ability to change the bid because Google is going to be doing the bids for me. And it says here bid strategy type is maximize conversions. So there you have it, five steps that you need to look for in order to improve the results of your search campaign. I really hope you enjoyed this video and stay tuned for future videos.
All right, thanks Ilana for this great information. If this video helped you out, then please hit that like button so we can share it more to other people. And if you want to find out more about AdWords tracking analytics, then check out this playlist right over there. And from everybody here at Measure School, happy measuring.